let us discuss about bacillus anthracis. Okay, so what is bacillus anthracis, what is its morphology, cultural characteristics, all these things we'll discuss in this lecture. Okay, so starting with bacillus anthracis is a gram positive bacilli. It is sporogenous, that means it forms spores, sporogenous, aerobic, facultative, anaerobic, non-motile, non-acid fast bacilli. Okay, it is a bacilli. Bacilli means rod shaped bacteria. Okay, it is a non-acid fast bacilli, non-motile, facultative, anaerobic, aerobic, sporogenous, that means it forms spores. Okay, spores are formed. It is gram-positive organism. It is one of the largest pathogenic bacteria. Okay, it is one of the largest pathogenic bacteria. Its measurements are 3 to 10 micrometers into 1 to 1.6 micrometers. This is measurement. See, these bacilli are arranged in the form of pairs, chains, or sometimes even singly also. So when they are arranged in chains, okay, when these bacilli are grown in media containing bicarbonate, okay, when bacilli is grown in media containing bicarbonate, or when incubated under 10 to 25% of carbon dioxide, or when it is grown in medium containing serum, albumin, charcoal, starch. So in all these conditions, when grown under bicarbonate containing medium, when grown in media containing 10 to 25% of carbon dioxide, when grown in medium containing serum, albumin, charcoal and starch, in all these conditions, this chain which is formed will be surrounded by a capsule. Okay, so this, when grown in all this condition, the chain which is formed by this bacilli will be surrounded by a capsule. Okay, will be surrounded by a capsule. This capsule, it is a polypeptide. It is made up of polymer of glutamic acid. Okay, see, medium containing serum, albumin, charcoal can form capsule without the presence of carbon dioxide. Okay, when a medium containing serum, albumin, starch is grown, when a medium containing these things will form capsule without the presence of carbon dioxide. We have to remember this. Okay, so the capsule is polypeptide. It is made up of polymer of glutamic acid. Then I told you these are spore forming, right? Let us discuss some points about this spore forming. As all of us know, spore formation will take place under unfavorable conditions, right? These forms are under unfavorable conditions. These spores are central or subterminal, elliptical or oval. And you see, these spores are of same width that of body of bacilli. Means, suppose this is bacilli. Okay, the spores which are formed are of same width that of the body of bacilli, so bulging will not take place. Hence, bulging will not take place because the spores are of same width that of body of bacilli. This spore formation will be enhanced by the presence of distilled water. Distilled water or 2% sodium chloride, or when grown under oxalated, when grown in oxalated agar. Oxalated agar. In all these condition, this spore formation will be enhanced. Even oxygen can enhance the formation of spore. Okay. And calcium chloride will inhibit the formation of spores. Okay, calcium chloride will inhibit the formation of spore. And this spore formation will take place in the culture. But not in animal body. This spore formation will take place when the bacillus in the culture or when the bacillus is in the soil. In these two places, spore formation will not take place. But this will not take place in the body of animal. Okay, you remember this. Then move into cultural characteristics. Cultural characteristics. I told you it is anaerobic, facultatively anaerobic. Okay, so the temperature required for this is 12 to 45 degrees. The optimum temperature is 35 to 37 degrees. This is optimum temperature, but the growth can also take place in this condition also, but the growth is very good under 35 to 37 degrees. And spore formation will be enhanced at 25 to 30 degrees. Between these range of temperature, the spore formation will be good. So in culture, you see, in the bacilli which is formed in culture will look as if they are bamboo stick, will give the appearance of bamboo stick appearance. Let us see what is this appearance. See, when I told you they are arranged in chains, right? They are arranged in chains. So some bacilli, there is truncateness at the ends. This is truncateness, right? Means they look as if they are cut at the ends. See here, they are cut. They look as if they are cut at the ends. So some are truncate. In some, what happens is these ends will look as they are concave. Will look like concave, like this. The ends are concave, like this. So some it is like this. In some, what happens is these ends will be bulged. The ends are will be enlarged. So it like this. Okay, the ends will be enlarged. This enlarged portion, they give the appearance of bamboo stick. This is what is called bamboo stick arrangement, and this is seen under eye power microscope. Okay, and this is bamboo stick appearance. Let us see how they look under in agar plates. See, in agar plates, the colonies are 2 to 3 mm in diameter. They are raised dull opaque colonies with frosted glass appearance. See, suppose these are colonies, right? You think these are colonies. If you see the edge of this or margin of this this colony under low power microscope. Low power microscope, we will see that these colonies will have interlacing. The chains will be interlacing like this. There will be interlacing chains like this. You will look under low power microscope. This will look like interlacing chains, and the gives matted appearance. Okay, this gives matted appearance. The oval appearance is called medusa head appearance. It's called medusa head appearance. It's called medusa appearance because these are chains, right? These chains are interlatching each other. Okay, and this gives matted hair appearance. Matted hair appearance. The whole appearance is called medusa head appearance. Medusa head appearance. Okay, this is how it looks in agar plate. Those bacteria that contains capsule, they form rough colonies. They form rough colonies. Those lacking this capsule, they form smooth colonies. Smooth colonies. And the next is gelatin strap culture. Gelatin strap culture. Let us see how it looks when strapped in gelatin. Suppose this is gelatin. Okay, this is gelatin. So when we stab in gelatin, the liquefaction starts from the top of the culture. Liquefaction starts from top of the culture. This gives appearance of inverted fidgety appearance. Inverted fidgety appearance. Because you see, the liquefaction is starting from top of the gelatin, right? And it is going down. So this gives the appearance of inverted fidgety appearance. Then we'll move to solid media containing penicillin. Containing 0.05 to 0.5 units of penicillin. Solid media in the sense it contains agar, right? So when we grow in a solid media containing 0.05 to 0.5 units of penicillin, the appearance will be string of peral reaction. Let us see what is this string of peral reaction. Here what happens is, suppose this is agar or solid media containing penicillin. What happens is the bacilli will become spherical and they are large. Okay, they become large spherical bodies, we can say. These large spherical bodies are arranged in the form of chain like this on the surface of agar. Okay, they are arranged in chain fashion on the surface of solid media. This gives appearance of string of peral. Hence this is called string of peral reaction. Okay, the importance of this string of peral reaction is that it differentiates between bacillus cereus and bacillus anthracis. Okay, it differentiates between bacillus cereus and bacillus anthracis. Then one more selective media that we have to remember here is plet media. Let us see what is this media. Plet media is a is a hot infusion agar added with added with polymyxin, then lysozyme, then ethylene diamine and ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid plus one more added is thiallus acetate. Okay, let medium is a selective medium for bacillus anthracis. It is nothing but it is a hot infusion agar added with polymyxin, lysozyme, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid and thiallus acetate. So the importance of this plate medium is it is useful for the growth of bacillus anthracis when a mixture of other spore forming bacteria are present. Okay, suppose if the specimen contains different spore forming bacilli, then when grown on with in this media, the growth of bacillus anthracis will be promoted and the growth of other media will be suppressed. Okay, as all of us know, what is selective media, right? So as all the other selective media, it also does the same work. Okay, this is about plate media and this is something about bacillus anthracis. In the next video, we will discuss about laboratory diagnosis. Thank you for watching.